Okay, hello again, YouTube. Just doing a quick video. Looks like we're gonna do a pickup video, even though I've kind of hate those. But since this is computer stuff, I picked up two computers yesterday, older computers. I mean, we're talking about $30 worth of stuff here. We got an old IBM computer, which I don't really know what this one is, but it has this A on it. I didn't take the monitor with it. It was in pretty bad shape. And the keyboard. But then I got also this Sony Vaio, which is a really cool, like, I mean, the reason why I picked it up is not because I need another computer. I have like way too many at this point. But it's got this really neat design. I love the colors and the color coordination. It's a neat little unit. I sort of powered these guys on and decrapified them yesterday, got all the drivers and whatnot. This one has a I don't know if these were added or if it came with it. But it has a Sound Blaster Live sound card in it, and it has an Asus, I think, ATI card in it, which does HD. So I was really surprised. Dual video out, VGA and DVI, sorry. So really impressive. And it came with the box, which you rarely see. It's got some goodies in here. I mean, but it's got the old like ball mouse from way back in the day. I always loved the design. Sony seems to put a great deal of effort into their designs, and it's got the recovery CDs as well. Sort of won't go too much into that. Just gonna show you guys a little bit of what I've got. got the this isn't set up properly. I kind of just have what I have laying around, like as far as tables and stuff go. But I've got the old iMac G3. I think that isn't a G3. That's an iMac, sorry, and a Performa from way back. I'm just kind of trying to set things up at the moment, and my old software collection. So I've got this whole kind of wall of old stuff. I got plenty of stuff in the closet, which I'll show you guys in a minute. But I just like to, pick up this stuff like this in games. I mean, I picked this up the other day, StarCraft 2. I was very curious about that. Unfortunately, I mean, I picked it up used for like $3, and this is the kind of thing that pisses me off about modern games is that everything is tied to a service now. You can't buy games like you used to be able to buy games. Like all of these games here, you can buy any day of the week, pop them in, play them. All right? You can sell them. But these new games, you can't do that. Right? All this other stuff too. I mean, pretty much pop it and play. But this guy is tied to the Blizzard service. I had to use one of the, it comes with four sort of guest passes, and stupid enough, it only gives you 7 hours of playtime with but I guess it's good enough to get a bit of an impression. I still got the one guest pass for it, but the other two guest passes are for World of Warcraft, which I kind of don't really have much interest in. So anyways, I sort of thought I'd show you guys this kind of like in development room. I'd like to sort of get, I have these pictures here of some of the oldest computers. That's the ENIAC from 1946. Just kind of, this room is for computing, pretty much. This is the UNIVAC from the 1960s. These are just printed out of my laser printer, which they kind of look like shit, but I'd like to get actual photographs of that and frame them with a little descriptor on it, and sort of, do some other stuff with that. This is kind of just the makings of the beginnings of a full-fledged computer room, but it's kind of just as I have the time. I'll kind of show you guys what else I picked up in a second. Just bear with me. Okay, so the other thing that I picked up the other week was like a week or so back was a Sun Microsystems keyboard. This is like brand new. The only thing that was wrong with it when I picked it up, the cord was wrapped around it, and the space bar was sort of wonky. And all I had to do was pop that up and reposition the bar spring. There's a little bar. It's like a C bar, and it's got a little spring on it on this side, and it works fine now. Took me like 20 seconds to fix that. The interesting part about this keyboard, though, is that it has all these other extended functions on the left, which I've never seen. But I think that's specific to the Sun operating system. I'm not really sure. Solaris, I believe it is. I used to work for an outfit that dealt with this kind of gear. This is mostly stuff you would see in higher end corporations and whatnot. Very expensive equipment. So I picked this up for $5. Really not sure if, yeah, it's PetSmart bag. Just anything to try to protect them. I don't want them to get all banged up, especially because it's new. And for $5, thought that was a pretty good deal. Nice little keyboard. But yeah, you know, I used to work for an outfit. Like I say, we used to deal with this stuff, you know, cataloging it. I'm in web, so I built their site and all that. It was really kind of fun. But as I say, you know, some of the systems, you know, you're talking tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of dollars for these computers back in the day. Of course, Sun was bought by Oracle back, I don't know, like 8 years ago, something like that, a long time ago anyways. And so Sun is gone, unfortunately. And so all the gear is pretty much, it's a buyer's market now. You can buy this stuff pretty cheap. The other thing I picked up was a, and yeah, the bags, you know, I try to protect things, you know, try not to throw this around, but I found this SideQuest drive, which I showed you guys in the, you know, back again video, the last one I did. But this one is a 135 meg drive. The interesting thing about the SideQuest drives was that it took these platter drives, like platter discs, I should say. They were a hard plastic disc, and if you, I don't know if I can show in there, you can barely see it, but there's reed heads in there. It was not an oxide, a magnetic oxide disc like the zip drive was, you know, but the problem with that was that this was very prone to failure. Any little bit of dust got in there, that this thing was finished. Not the drive itself, I think it was actually the discs that would have problems. But we used to use these in high school. I mean, this is like way, way back. I don't even know what interface that is. I think that's serial or something. That's like way back. If you guys know, tell me what that is. I'm not particularly well-versed. Unfortunately, it didn't come with a power supply. That actually might be SCSI by the looks of it, because you have the channel selector here. So that could be just SCSI. I don't know what that is. But yeah, I don't have a power supply. I don't have any discs, unfortunately. The discs are extremely hard to find. Because basically what happened back in the day was in the 90s, you had the zip drive, you had the super disc, you had SideQuest. There was all these drives coming out at the time trying to compete with getting more space because hard drives were still super fucking expensive. And it was very, very cost prohibitive to just sort of buy a new hard drive to extend your storage. So these kind of filled in the gap. And then what happened was CDs, the writable CDs came in and basically destroyed that entire market. I think zip drives outdid the SideQuest. SideQuest was kind of a short-lived thing, so far as I understand. We didn't have them around very long. I didn't see them for very long. And I have a whole zip drive collection. You very rarely see these. That's why I picked this one up. So I got it for like $3. But I keep it in a little bag, just, you know, keep it in good condition or whatever. Put it in my archive, whatever. I don't know that I'll ever use it. But anyways, that's what I picked up. And, you know, hopefully I'll be doing a little more videos soon. I just wanted to show you guys a little bit of what I picked up lately and what I've been into. Mostly it's the retro computing stuff. And as I say, here's sort of a little preview of what's going on in my head as far as like putting some kind of computer room together. I still have a Mac Classic in my closet. I got all kinds of stuff in the closet. I got to sort through and get some, you know, proper tables and stuff for, but, or shelving. And hopefully I can turn this room into a nice little retro computer museum room /, I don't know, curiosities room. We'll see what happens. But yeah, that's it for now, guys. I'll do another video here soon. Thanks for watching.